Okay, I would like to show you a really cool procedural drawing that you could do yourself straight away, right now. It's called a Hitomizashi stitch pattern. It's a way of visibly mending clothes, and usually they are very rigid in their pattern, but since we're mathematicians, we can play around with some probabilities and see what we can do. Do you want to give me some ones and zeros?
What do you want me to do? Just say some numbers?
So I actually love this, different ways of finding ones and zeros. So why don't you give me a phrase and we'll do the vowels ones and the consonants zeros.
May the force be with you.
Okay. May the force be with you. Okay. So as long as you've
Where's the you?
Oh.
All right.
Didn't come here to spell. So as long as you've got two different states, you can do this. So it can be ones and zeros, vowels and consonants, odds and evens. Like, play around with it. Find a good way that you want to decide if you are starting on or off. So we're doing vowels, we're going to start off. Consonants, we're going to start on. And what I mean by that is this, it's stitching. So M, consonant, please. So we're going to start on, which means right from the get-go, I'm going to put a stitch there, miss one, put one here, miss one, put one here, miss one, put one here. Okay, and just as if you were stitching clothes, we're going to stitch along the way. Okay, next one, A, is a vowel, so we're starting off. So I'm going to miss one to start with. It's just one phase over. So miss one, and then I'm going to put my stitch here, here, and here. Okay, and I'm going to continue on. Why, vowel or consonant?
It's a consonant.
And that likes to pretend it's a vowel. Now we have a nice little wave going across the way and we need our stitches going vertical. But we just use pi for that? We'll just use the digits of pi, odds and evens? Okay. I like finding fun ways of deciding what you're gonna do. Okay, so we'll go 3, 1. 4, 1, 5, 9, 2, 6, 3, 5, 8, 9.
Now you're just shutting off.
3.14159265358973233823423832733837950. Well
done. 0288
for 1971.
You could be making it up and I wouldn't know.
So same thing again, but we're going to do odds, we'll start off, evens, we'll start on, and we'll go down the way.
Cool.
Yeah, it's a nice picture. It's fun to procedurally generate things. So this came from May the Force Be With You and Pi. It's a cool way to add randomness into your drawing. The cool thing you can do with this is you can then go and color it in. As far as I found, they're always too colorable, which makes sense to me, but I don't know if there's a proof out there, but you can always color it in with just two colors. But I think we can do a little bit better. I think we can investigate this further. So one thing to think about in maths when you learn something new, this is now some knowledge that you have, is think, how could I change this? What are the limits? What could I do with this? Immediately, I thought, that's really nice. Like, I like how it looks on a square grid, but I wonder what it would look like on an ISO grid. So where you've got your 30 or 60 degrees. So I put it onto an ISO grid. And then I wondered, what would the differences be if you changed how random it was? So pi, probably normal, probably got an even distribution of odds and even numbers. May the force be with you, that's a bit random. But what if we did something like saw maybe a 10% chance of putting down a 1, and then a 20% chance of putting down a 1, and so on. What do you think you would see happening in the pattern? Would there be anything to see? Is it totally random? If it was completely 0% chance of getting a 1, so it's just all zeros, you're all starting in the off state, what do you think is going to happen?
Well, you'll just get like big straight lines and shoots that you could fold down and things like that.
Yeah, it looks a lot more rigid. So, I mean, I've switched it up onto the ISO paper just so that we can play around with it. Always have fun with your maths, play around with it, enjoy it. Let's see what this looks like. Okay, so if you are always starting in your off state, and then we'd have to do it in this direction here. And one more direction to go this way.
Oh, there's three now.
Yeah, uh-huh. You know, always, you can just add another dimension to things. Okay, totally rigid. You know, you can see a pattern going on there. And that is the probability of starting in the on position is 0. And the probability of starting in the off position is 1. And then you just introduce more and more randomness to it. So my question is, once we get to the probability of the on position being 0.9, do you think that's going to be incredibly random, less random? What do you think is going to happen there?
Intuitively, you'd think it just becomes a little bit less random, but I've also made enough of these videos to know that introducing just a little bit of change can make things go chaotic on me, so...
Yes, it's not chaotic. I do love when chaotic things happen, but this is not chaotic. Probability of starting on, we're going to go with 0.1. Probability of starting off is 0.9. Now we need to randomly generate these. Okay, cool. And now I'll make this into a picture. Okay, so this is what it looks like now that we've got the probability of starting in the on position, 0.1. So there's a 1 in 10 chance of starting in the on position. It came up a little bit more than 1 in 10, but that happens. It's still a 1 in 10 chance that it would have happened.
What do I interpret from that? It kind of...
It looks... Well, what do you think? Do you think it looks wildly different? Same?
A couple of times, you know, obviously it looks the same down that part, and then it looks like it's gone a bit skew-if there.
Yeah, so you can think of this as like the baseline pattern. This is it with no randomness, and then we've introduced a little bit of randomness, so you can see there are some similarities, there are some differences. I got this wrong when I made my first prediction about what was going to happen when I started playing around with the randomness of this pattern. I thought, you know, it starts rigid, that makes sense, and then as I get more and more random, it's going to get progressively more weird looking and chaotic, perhaps. I was wrong. So I think that you can get it from what's going on here, but actually the point where it becomes most random and least looking like this is at the 50-50 mark. And then it starts becoming rigid again, but one phase out. And that's because if you are starting in the on position, you know, with a 0.1 percentage or 0.1 probability, then your off position is 0.9. When you get to 0.9, they've just flipped over, so you're in essence doing the same thing. You've got the same probability going on again at 0.9. So do you want to see what 0.5 would look like, the most random one? And then we'll have a look at the probability switched over. And this is where the most hectic pattern happens. Okay. Yep, it's pretty hectic looking. It's pretty unrecognizable from the first one. Nice pattern, a little bit more random, and then you can see it's kind of losing the plot a bit. It's a nice way to say that. It is getting hectic in here. And then it gets progressively more rigid again and goes back into another pattern. Okay, so now the probability of starting on is gonna be 0. We're not gonna start on at all. And the probability of starting off, certainty, that is happening.
So that's the mirror of that one?
Yeah, it kind of looks like it just moves over a wee bit. Starting on each time, and ready for the massive anticlimactic surprise that it did not, in fact, become more and more random. It got more random up to 0.5 and then became less random again, and it looks exactly the same. It's just moved over a wee bit. You should always just think, what can you change? What can you play around with? Make a prediction, see if you want, like, you know, if you want to guess what's happening. Or you could just see what happens, just play around with things and see what happens.
So this is used by people who are, like, sewing and stitching things?
Yeah, uh-huh. So if you, like, if you get a hole in your pocket or your sock or whatever, you can stitch it on the front. And it looks really cool. Who wouldn't want that stitched on the front of their shirt, you know?